When Amy Hines rescued 19-pound Garrett from a raggedy shelter in Kansas, he was just hours away from being euthanized.
He was at the shelter just sitting there with a broken pelvis, not getting any care.
Come on, Garrett.
She healed him at her shelter in DeSoto and then sent him to a foster home to regain the rest of his strength. His first day there, he slipped his collar on a walk and was gone. Hines wasn't contacted until that night.
If you can get out there immediately, you have a good chance of seeing where he went. But the next step is to just paper the area with flyers, which we did.
The flyers brought calls right away. Garrett was seen near the Merle Hay Cemetery. Then he headed north. Someone saw him near the skating rink on Meredith, then at Hyperion Golf Club. Hines searched Camp Dodge and got reports from as far north as the mile-long bridge. She was determined.
From the minute I tell a shelter that I will take a dog, I'm responsible for that dog.
But by then, the snowstorm and bitter cold had hit. It seemed Garrett's long road had ended near Sailorville.
The last place anybody spotted him was in a cornfield up there. And then we didn't hear anything for almost a month.
Rescue volunteers maintained a ray of hope. Garrett had stayed alive for 3 months on his own.
He knew where to find food, obviously, knew where to find shelter. So I don't know, maybe he did that in his life before he ended up in the shelter in Kansas.
2 weeks ago, Linda Fetters looked out her front window.
I knew that was him.
She'd seen one of the flyers, and she called Amy Hines.
I called Sue, and I said, you know, somebody thinks Garrett's in Pleasant Hill.
Fetters followed his tracks through the snow, along fence lines, and through parking lots and yards.
There were two boys, and they were standing by the front door, and I said, have you seen a little scruffy-looking dog? And they said, you just missed him. He's 10 minutes ahead of you.
Over the next 10 days, she and Sue Strom would search for Garrett, even see him from time to time. But they couldn't catch him.
When dogs are on their own like that, they get into a crazy mindset where they're just surviving.
They set box traps for him.
And then we caught a cat, and then another cat, and then a possum, big possum.
But never Garrett.
It was getting very hard to sleep at night.
Last Friday, Fetters left the trap out all night. She checked it at 6 a.m.
I hear this little growl, and it didn't sound like a coon. And so I bent over and I was like, well, hello. And he was just like, where you been?
Over 4.5 months in an Iowa winter, Garrett had survived on roadkill, traveling from the northwest corner of the metro to the far east side. Fetters decided immediately to keep him. An incredible journey.
I think Linda's his angel, and it was just a matter of time for him. Get over here.
No one knows why he did it or how he pulled it off, but Garrett's road ended at the home he's never had. And that's all that really matters. In Pleasant Hill, Andy Fales, Channel 13 News. What is it that could tear us away from a holiday at home? Make us choose cold fingers over a warm couch.
You know, we should be watching football, but this was more exciting.
Seriously?
Yes. Seriously.
What? Geese on the water? The Des Moines River shivering its way underneath?
Usually on holidays, our kids are all older, so we'll just go out for a drive and look for wildlife of some kind.
They didn't have to go far today, maybe a half mile from downtown, as the eagle flies.
I counted on the first two or three trees, and there were over 20. Just there.
I've never seen this many eagles in one spot at one time.
I had to work earlier today, but I came out here as soon as I got off work because I knew the eagles were down here. So, you just missed one catching a fish.
Not everybody missed it, but there was so much action that you didn't need one of those big lenses. A cell phone would do.
There goes. I got it too.
According to the DNR, the eagles like this spot because the water here is still running fast enough to stay open. But you can see the ice creeping in from the sides, and eventually it too will freeze over, and the eagles will have to move on.
You just don't see this every day.
Got to be, what, 40 or 50 of them probably.
It wasn't long ago that the pesticide DDT had them on the endangered species list. Viewings like this were unthinkable, but now here they are, putting on a New Year's Day air show, one worth a trip out into the cold.
Great way to start a new year. What better way?
In Des Moines, Andy Fales, Channel 13 News. You won't see it from the road, and they don't do any advertising. But that doesn't keep business from finding the Luthery shop.
It's pretty much nonstop.
How busy are owners Scott Roden, Bill Hens, and Tim Thielen?
Incredibly busy.
So busy, work is backed up for months. So busy, they have to lock the front door to catch up.
Usually for a few days, sometimes a week. This last time it was 2 weeks.
Midwestern guitarist will tell you there are two reasons why the place is in such a pickle.
I know they do great work.
Work that almost no one else can do. From fine detailing on priceless classics to bona fide resurrections.
It's not out of the ordinary to see somebody come in and say, I just backed over my guitar in the driveway.
You'd think they'd just hire more help, but you see,
it's not the kind of job where you can just come in and, okay, I like to, the guitars are cool, I'm gonna work on them.
I would love to hire somebody to do this part of it.
The other problem is what's going on the other side of the room. After years of restoring instruments, they began making new ones. Built guitars are handmade and custom designed with a look that stands apart.
I love them. You're not going to miss it, and the Built logo's nice and big.
Local players like Brandon Darner and Josh Davis jumped on board right away. But a national following was tougher.
It's a tough nut to crack if you're trying to do something completely different. It's going to be really hard to convince people that this is what they need.
Guitarists are notoriously conservative about their instruments, and the Built guitars...
It's different, you know, it doesn't look like any other current production guitar.
But the craftsmanship was undeniable, and it wasn't long before a big name agreed to try one out.
Nels Klein from Wilco.
Rolling Stone cheers Nels Klein of Wilco as a true guitar hero. And when he first strapped on a Built a few years ago, Thielen and Hens were in the crowd.
The singer, Jeff Tweedy, had actually shouted out, you know, looks like Nels got a new guitar today from Des Moines. And, you know, that was a cool feeling.
Validated. Dave Kooning of the Killers followed suit, and then others. And now, standing out is a good thing.
If you're a guitar player, you have to ask those questions. You have to look, what is that guitar about?
The story is all over the guitar world's print media too, prompting more orders still.
We seem to have hit on something that people were kind of looking for.
If the success has spirits soaring, it only takes a quick glance around the shop to crash things back to earth. Sooner or later, they're going to need to hire more help. There is a national demand to meet, and it's growing.
All of us are Iowans. We're proud of seeing guys in Iowa that are doing something cool make it outside of Iowa.
Hard work by skilled hands. Pride in the results of a day's work. That's how Iowa icons begin. In a small shop in Des Moines, there's one on its way, striking for us a local chord on the national stage. Andy Fales, Channel 13 News. The double take started with new baby-faced head coach Garrison Carter.
The parents were like, who is that? Is he a player?
Then it was his system. Who throws the ball this much in Class 1A?
Passing is so much more fun.
I thought it was awesome.
Ready, cut!
As a junior, Caleb Fry broke every passing record at Ogden.
I was just having fun.
This year, it's the receivers who have fans looking twice at one name on the stat sheet. West. At Van Meter, he grabbed the school record for receiving yards.
Stepped up and had a huge game, and it was his first game starting for us at wide receiver.
Following week against Colfax, West again. Same record, new mark.
And it started off with that one-handed grab I had.
The thing is, West is one name with two faces. Jake and Luke West. Jake got the record first.
Oh, shoot.
Luke has it now.
What you got?
If you're confused, think of the opposing defenses.
We go twins right, we have, you know, twins right, for real. We have two twins standing right next to each other on the right side of the field.
No.
It's a rivalry that goes back to the delivery room and has no boundaries.
I'm PlayStation 3, he's Xbox. Let's go, man.
but that's nothing compared to the receiving record.
Deep down, I'm a little mad, so now I'm pushing this week. I'm like, I'm going to beat you this week.
And I think, you know, you got to credit them being Twins to a lot of their success.
When Twins do well, chances are the team does too. And Ogden is 5-1 for the first time in over a decade.
Ah, good play, good play.
People are standing on the sidelines.
It's so much fun.
Footballs!
South Hamilton is next on the schedule. It's a game Bulldog fans usually write off as a loss. But these days, things are worth a second look here in Ogden. Andy Fales, Channel 13 Sports. It was hard to decide what was more impressive, the sight of St. Paul's in the evening, or the sound of its carillon ringing into the street. The sound of a handmade organ filling the cathedral as the sun streamed in, or the sight of the man who was making all the music in his cycling shirt.
I started writing Ragbri in 1985, and I've ridden 26.
It isn't often David Raymond can mix his two passions.
Occasionally on Ragbri, I would find a lovely country church and an organ in a country church.
There was the time he played St. Wenceslaus in Spillville. But this was even better. After all, this is Raymond's church.
We thought this would be a nice opportunity to showcase something different, showcase the organ, and show people one of Des Moines' oldest churches.
The audience just loved it. All right, this is a church after all.
So we know there's a number of people in the Ragbri ridership that very much enjoy classical music.
Rock and roll riders had their fun down by the river, and these had theirs. In front of an artist in his medium. Inside stone and glass set 128 years ago on a fine night on the trail. In Des Moines, Andy Fales, Channel 13 News.